Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering channel. I am thankful to all of the viewers who have subscribed to this channel and those who have watched the videos but not yet subscribed to the channel are requested to please subscribe the channel and click the bell icon to get all updates from this channel. So in today's video, we will be discussing or solving the numericals related to heat transfer operations. We have discussed various theoretical aspects in our lecture number 1 and lecture number 2, but now it's time to do some numerical problems here as well. So in numerical number 1, we have been given that a 10 cm diameter copper ball, so a copper ball is given whose diameter is of 10 cm, is to be heated from 100 to an average temperature of 150 degree centigrade in 30 minutes. So this is a copper ball. We have to increase its temperature from 100 to 150 in 30 minutes in this temperature range, taking the average density to be 8950 kg per cubic meter and specific heat of copper to be 0.395 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade. So this is the overall information which is given to us, and what we need to determine: number 1, the total amount of heat which is transferred to the copper ball in moving its temperature from 100 to 150 degree centigrade. Number 2, the average rate of heat transfer to the ball. Number 3, the average heat flux. In the heat transfer rate, obviously the time will be involved here, along with the time area will be involved as per our previous theoretical knowledge. So first we will discuss the assumptions and properties. In assumptions, we will assume that the constant properties can be used for the copper at average temperature. What are these constant properties? The average density and specific heat. Density is 8950 kg per cubic meter, while Cp, which is specific heat of copper at constant pressure, is 0.395 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade. So first we will calculate the total heat which is transferred to copper ball to convert its temperature or to increase its temperature from 100 to 150 degree centigrade. First law of thermodynamics, which we have discussed in our previous lecture, that the total amount of heat which is transferred to a system is equal to the change in its internal energy or a total rise in its energy contents of the system. So it can be said that energy transfer to the system is equal to energy increase of the system. We can mathematically talk it about as Q is equal to delta U, and delta U is equal to mc dt. M denotes the mass, C the specific heat, T2 outlet temperature or final temperature, T1 initial temperature. And how M is calculated? Because it is currently unknown that rho, which is density, multiplied by the volume. And volume formula is pi by 6 d cube. So we know the d, the 10 centimeter diameter, converting it to meter, it will be 0.1 meter. Density we have been given 8950 kg per cubic meter. So the cubic meter will be cancelled out in the equation, and we will get mass as 4.69 kg of copper ball. So we have initially estimated the copper ball mass. Now we know the M, we know the C, we know T2, T1. 4.69 kg multiplied by 0.395 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade multiplied by 150 minus 100. So it will give final answer of Q is equal to 92.6 kilojoule. So it shows that 92.6 kilojoule of heat should be transferred to the copper ball in raising its temperature from 100 to 150 degree centigrade. Now moving to the second part, which is average heat transfer rate, and it includes a factor of delta T. Now we have to increase the temperature from 100 to 150 degree centigrade in 30 minutes as given in the problem statement here as well. So what we need to do, that Q dot, which shows the average heat transfer rate, is equal to Q over delta T. We have calculated Q from our analysis number 1, which is 92.6 kilojoule, and kilojoule per second is equal to kilowatt. So we have converted 30 minutes to second, which means 1800 seconds, and it will give answer as Q dot is equal to 51.4 watt. Kilojoule per second is equal to kilowatt. However, its answer will be in points, decimal places. So multiplying it with 1000 will give answer in watt, which is 15.4 watt. The last one, average heat flux, where we will be adding the impact of area. And it is Q dot, small q dot now, is equal to capital Q dot, which is calculated in analysis number 2, divided by area. And area is calculated as pi d square. Again, we know the value of d, which is 0.1. So watt per square meter, pi value is 3.1415. And Q dot is calculated from the previous. So it is small q dot, which is heat flux, is 1636 watt per square meter. So this is how the heat transfer rate, the average heat transfer, the heat flux, these all values are calculated, and we have initially studied it theoretically. Now we have solved it using numerical. So this was the first numerical of our today's activity. Now going to the second numerical, And in that numerical, we have been given that 1.2 kg of liquid water initially at 15 degrees centigrade is to be heated to 95 degrees centigrade in a teapot equipped with 1200 watt electric heating element inside. That it contains 1.2 kg of water. This teapot, the water initially at 15 degrees centigrade and is then heated to 95 degrees centigrade using this heater. The teapot is 0.5 kg. The weight of this teapot is 0.5 kg and has an average specific heat of 0.7 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade, taking the specific heat of water to be 4.18 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade and disregarding any heat loss from the teapot. Means we are not assuming any heat loss in the system. We are simply assuming total heat balance in the system, that heat in is equal to heat out, there is no heat loss. Determine how long it will take for the water to be heated. So the given example, if we summarize it, that there is a water which is present in teapot, we have to heat it using electric heater. We have to calculate how much time will it take to heat water from 15 degrees centigrade to 95 degrees centigrade. Now the assumptions are that there is no heat loss from teapot, constant properties can be used, and the constant properties include every specific heat for teapot is 0.7 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade, while that for water is 4.18 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade. Now for the analysis part, if we talk about the overall energy balance of the system, that is E in minus E out is equal to delta E of the system, that the energy which is supplied minus energy out is equal to total energy rise of the system. And E in is equal to delta U of system, which includes both water and teapot. Now, delta U is calculated as we have seen before, mc dt for water and mc dt for teapot. We note the value of m for water and for teapot as well. We note the c for both of them. And we know the overall delta T, which is 95 to 15 for both water and teapot. So 1.2 multiplied by 4.18 multiplied by 95 minus 15 for water. For teapot, 0.5 kg mass, 0.7 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade specific heat, and 95 to 15. So once we sum it, it gives an E in of 429.3 kilojoule. Now all this can be achieved by using an electric heater whose capacity is 1200 watt. So how we can calculate it? That delta T can be calculated as total energy transferred, which is in kilojoule, divided by the rate of energy transfer. So E in, which we have calculated, 429.3 kilojoule divided by 1.2 kilojoule per second. Now this 1200 watt is converted to 1.2 kilowatt by divided by 1000, and 1 kilowatt is equal to 1 kilojoule per second. So that kilojoule will be cancelled with kilojoule and we will get answer in seconds, which is delta T is equal to 358 seconds, approximately 5.97 minutes. So we need ideally 5.97 minutes to raise the temperature of water from 15 to 95 degrees centigrade in a heater. But obviously in a real-time system, the time requirement will be higher than that. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Please stay tuned for more exciting videos on heat transfer operations.